evening. So, one of my sons asked me the other night if boys can be elected mayor in Boston. They have been, and they will again someday, but not tonight. On this day, Boston elected your mom. Because from every corner of our city, Boston has spoken. We are ready to meet this moment. We are ready to become a Boston for everyone. We're ready to be a Boston that doesn't push people out, but welcomes all who call our city home. We're ready to be a Boston where all can afford to stay and to thrive. And yes, Boston is ready to become a Green New Deal city. We are ready for every Bostonian to know that we don't have to choose between generational change and keeping the streetlights on, between tackling big problems with bold solutions and filling our potholes, to make change at scale and at street level. We deserve both.
How does it feel being a first Asian or first Tibetan American ever to be elected as a mayor in the United States?
It is incredibly humbling. I'm just so honored to have achieved that first for our community, to continue to remind the people in this country of the incredible contributions that the Tibetan people have made in the United States and around the world. To continue to keep our international plight and diaspora at the front of our government leaders. My mom is a refugee like so many other Tibetans. She grew up in a refugee camp in India, made it to college where she met my father, who's from Punjab, and they immigrated of all places in 1980 to Ohio. And in just one generation, my family went from being refugees to now the first Asian American mayor of Cincinnati, the first Asian American mayor in the Midwest. That's just an incredible journey, and I'm so grateful to be a part of it.